become big and brave in crime?
Well, I had a gift of the gab, and yeah. I used to entertain people. But when you get into secondary school, mm. you know, that's not good enough. You need to pass exams. So I was kicked out of school, and then that cycle began.
Well, let's just talk about crime for a moment, because although they say that 1 in 10 people in this country is dyslexic, and that, of course, is bad enough, in prisons the figures are even more alarming. And yet there's only one project in the country that helps dyslexic prisoners, and that is in Pentonville prison in London.
Before I came to prison, I never used to read or write. Only postcards when I used to go on holiday. But now, I'm writing to my parents, writing to my girlfriend, reading. I don't know why, I'm like a little bookworm. Even my cellmate's getting upset with me because I don't play cards anymore, I don't play dominoes anymore. I'm either writing or I'm reading. I know I was dyslexic quite a long time before I actually came into prison. So when I found out there was a dyslexic course, I decided to give my name and number so that I could be tested to get on the course, so that I could get help with reading and writing and stuff.
It's estimated that as many as 1 in 3 prisoners may be dyslexic, though proper studies have never been done. It's a problem which begins in schools, where some children can be allowed to fall behind by as many as 4 years before their dyslexia is spotted.
Now, if you're one of those children, what might happen to you is you get frustrated, your self-esteem goes, you start mucking about in the class. Now, we all know there's a strong link between dyslexia and that kind of behaviour at school. Children who start truanting get into serious big-time trouble. So it's not surprising, therefore, there are links between educational problems and eventually getting into real trouble with the law.
Midge. Lodge. Midge. Midget.
The Pentonville Dyslexia Course is the only one of its kind in the country. The first recognition and attempted remedy of a massive problem among prison inmates.
Where we've been able to assess dyslexic inmates, we've never been able to constructively do anything with them. You can confirm that they are dyslexic, and then what do you do with them? I think, as you've seen today, they're just quite elated. I mean, they're actually able to come here and do something for themselves and take control of their learning.
Quite a few of the students we've had in this class have decided to opt out of workshops, for example, in the prison and go on to full-time education within the prison system here. And some of the students on this course now feel sufficiently confident that when they're actually out, they will actually try and pursue the education that they missed on years ago.
Changed my life. It's like giving me confidence to go for it and that. Whereas before I used to steer away from that because I wasn't very good. Well, I used to think I wasn't very good at it. But now I know I can do it. And with the help of this course, it's certainly opened up new roads for me. And I feel it can do that for a great many people. Certainly if it's done it for me.
Although in its first year, the course is already massively oversubscribed. A new dawn, a new light is rising over Pentonville.
I'm a firm advocate that they just have shame indelibly written on their foreheads. So to raise that self-esteem and to actually make them autonomous learners here and to constructively do something about their disability, for want of a better word, or their word blindness, I think it's called, it can only improve on those factors.
Since this course has been along, a lot of people don't look down on dyslexia. A lot of people, even the rough boys in prison, are coming forward and saying, I might have a problem. There's not much stigma about it anymore. They know it's a problem. It's just getting over it.
Well, I've been joined by Jane.